We want to make sure we cover our city as faith leaders. That is our assignment, to pray for it. Chronicles 7 and 14 says that those people who are called by my name, that's what we say we are, right? We'll humble ourselves, turn from our wicked ways, seek God's face. All right, we ain't going to do all that right now, but come on here. Minister Abdul Haq Muhammad, which is my son, brother. I want to thank Dawn Haynes and Minister Sharif. Lord have mercy. Amenhotep, I made the call this morning. We're going to start doing more things with BCPC, because how can you have peace without faith? So we want to make sure, hear me, y'all, that when they call us, that we come. And sometimes we need to just show up whether they call or not. So BCPC, Dawn, Sister Sharice, Sharif, thank you for coming out, making sure we got some sound. And I want the heavens to hear us. We thank God for Mayor Raz J. Baraka under his leadership. We've been praying. Hello, Reverend Marquise. We've been praying, covering, tilling this ground. And today we're going to start out with this prayer on the steps of City Hall as we move into a season of thanksgiving, even though every day we should be giving thanks for life and what's taking place in our city. We want to make sure everyone knows that there's some faith that believe and that will cover. And now I'm disconnected, so I'm going to have to turn it over.
Testing 1-2, Black Power 1, Black Power 2.
Black Power 1, Black Power. Here, take you. You take this Black Power. Here you go.
In the name.
Now I gotta introduce you right. Minister Abdul Haq Muhammad. Come on, y'all, put your hands together for this brother that's getting ready to speak truth to our God. Amen.
Assalamu alaikum. In the name of Allah, the beneficent, the most merciful, once again, I'm Brother Abdul Haq Muhammad, the student minister of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan for the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. You know, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan have taught us that hopelessness is the mother of violence. That hopelessness is the mother of violence. So the Bible says that we are saved by hope. And as community faith leaders, that's what we are out here to do, to instill hope in our people and let our people know that this tragic circumstance that happened, it does not define us. Nor does it negate the work that we have been doing. We are not new to this. We've been working all summer. And every season we've been working, we've been praying, we've been resolving conflicts. And we're going to continue to do what we have already been doing. So this one tragic incident, it does not define who we are, nor does it define what we are. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan said, do we have problem children or do our children have a problem? He said, and if our children have a problem, they are not the cause, but they are the effect, because children do what is natural until they learn what is normal. So violence is not a North problem, it's an American problem. When we were taken from our homeland, that was an act of violence. When we were kidnapped, that was an act of violence. So much of what we see is the effect of a cause that we had nothing to do with. But we are going to use our resources, our intelligence, our faith, and our hope in God to resolve this issue. This issue that's plaguing North, plaguing New York, plaguing Philadelphia, plaguing Chicago. So we are going to pray that God will bless us, give us the spirit and the courage to go forth in his name and continue to heal our people and give hope to them. As community faith leaders, our work is in the unseen, because our work is spiritual and our problem is spiritual. Therefore, it necessitates a spiritual solution. And that's what we're out here to do. So we thank you for coming. We thank you for showing up. And I want to say that what's happening in our community and in our city, everybody is responsible. It's not on one person and not on another. It's not just on the mayor and not on you. We're all responsible. So we don't want to make this a reactionary finger pointing session where we say who's not doing what. Everybody is doing something, and what we're doing, we could be doing better, and we need to do more. So it's not just on you and not on me. It's not just on me and it's not on you. We got to cut the bystander apathy. everybody who is a part of this community is responsible. Because the African proverb says that it takes a village to raise a child. But the subsequent proverb says that the child that is not embraced by the village will burn the village down in order to fill the village's warmth. So community reaction is good, but community interaction is better.
Right.
How can we stop the violence? When you see that young man walking, don't just walk past him. Speak to him or her. That's how you stop it, just communicating. Or do when you walk past young people, you just walk past them and you are too afraid to give them a kind word, a head nod, a good gesture. So it starts with those small things, us just talking and communicating. Everybody that walk past you is a part of your community and you should talk to them, you should know them. That's how you stop the violence, with just the small things. It don't take a big thing, it takes a small thing. And that small thing is our community interaction. So thank you all for coming. We're going to pray. We're not going to be long, but we're going to be strong. So thank you all. As-salamu alaykum.
Thank you. Thank you, Minister Abdul Haq. We're going to do our first prayer with Pastor Brenda Bird. We're not going to do sermons. Y'all know how I say, because I want to give you all an opportunity, because that's what we came to do. We came to pray. So Pastor Brenda Bird will do our first prayer. Representing our Latino community will be Pastor Nieves, praying in Spanish. After Pastor Nieves has prayed, Minister Malik, representing our 21-year-old, this young man here is one of our soldiers in the community, in the faith community. After Minister Malik has prayed, we want to hear from BCPC for a brief word, because they're our partners in this work in the community. In that order.
Good morning. We came to pray. Amen. Let's just pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, oh God, we come together as a community, Lord God. We come together, oh God, to cry out for our city, to cry out for our children, to cry out for our community. And so, God, your word says that if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their own wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven, forgive their sin and heal their land. Lord God, we come together, oh God, united as one. Lord God, asking you to smile upon our community, to look upon our youth, look upon our seniors, look upon our community, look upon our mayor and the leaders. Lord God, we need you, oh God. We come today to cry out for our community. We cry out today because we know that you are Almighty God and you can do all things but fail. So we cry out to you today, Lord God, and ask you to look upon North, to smile upon North. Lord God, that you would change the hearts, oh God, of our people. Lord God, that they would know that they're loved, that they would know that we appreciate them, that they would know that we're praying for them, that they know that we are pushing for them. And oh God, we just thank you. Thank you for every leader. Lord, every community servant that is here today, we join our forces to call upon the God of heaven, hallelujah, that you would move in our community. So God, we thank you today. We thank you for unity. We thank you for love. We thank you for humanity. We thank you for a heart and a goal to work together to see a better North. And so God, we thank you. As our mayor said in his address, I am North, hallelujah, and I am proud of it. And so we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Padre, venimos ante tu presencia, Señor, dándote a ti toda la honra y toda la gloria, Señor. ¿Cuál es tú que te la mereces, Padre? Pero en este momento, Señor, venimos ante tu presencia, Señor, pidiéndote, Señor, como en la unidad que estamos aquí parados, Señor, pidiéndote, Señor, por esta ciudad, Señor, lo que ha sucedido en esta ciudad, Padre. Pero en estos momentos, Señor, proclamamos, Señor, sanidad sobre esta ciudad en estos momentos, Padre, también. También te pedimos, Señor, que tú te glorifiques de una manera especial, Señor, sobre esta ciudad, Señor, que la hemos proclamado para ti, Señor. Reprendemos y atamos, Señor, toda violencia, Padre, que has levantado contra esta ciudad en estos momentos. Santo, Padre. También te pedimos, mira, las matanzas que han sucedido, Padre. Te pedimos, Señor, que tú le des paz y tranquilidad, Señor, a las familias, Señor, que han perdido un ser querido en estos momentos, Padre. Pero también te pedimos, Señor, paz y tranquilidad, Señor, para esta ciudad, Señor. Que en estos momentos, Señor, la proclamamos para ti, Señor, y solamente para ti, Padre. Por eso te pedimos, Señor, que tú limpies los aires, Señor, limpies la atmósfera, Señor, en estos momentos, Señor. Atamos y reprendemos, Señor, toda trampa del enemigo, Padre, que trata de levantarse contra esta ciudad, Señor, y contra, Padre, también el que está encargado de esta ciudad, Padre. Así te lo pedimos, Señor, dando hasta ti toda la honra y toda la gloria. Amén.
Father, we thank you once again for the opportunity that you have allowed us to come into this city to pray. Now, God, we pray now that, God, you will cover the children, oh God. That, God, that you will touch every mother. You will touch every father. You will touch every leader. You will touch, oh God, right now, oh God, that every child that has to go to school, oh God, that you will wrap your loving arms around them. That, God, that you are a God who are a God who sees and knows all. But, God, we thank you for your spirit of protection. We thank you for your spirit of love. We thank you for your spirit of victory. We say thank you for your mercy and your grace. We say thank you for just being a God of a second chance. Oh God, we come right now just to give you the glory, to give you the honor, and to give you the praise. Because it ain't no goodness of our own, but it's the hand of the Lord that's upon us. So we say thank you, oh God, for giving us the opportunity to come together just to lift you up, just to glorify you. So now, God, we pray right now for the community, oh God, that you will strengthen us, oh God, not just as a family, but all as collectively. Because when you bless one, you bless all. So God, we pray right now for the young folks, oh God, that God, you will look down upon them, that God, you will give them strength to walk the street, to let them know that they are victorious, that they are beautiful, that they are a royal priesthood, and they are yours, oh God. So God, we pray right now, God, that you will wrap your loving arms around all of us, oh God, not just on the young folks, but everybody, oh God, who lives in the city of North New Jersey. So we come in, we pray, oh God, that you continue to stay with us. You continue to be with us, oh God. God, it ain't no accident, but you have allowed us to come on this city hall, on the steps of city hall, to give you the glory, to lift up your name. And so now, God, we cast Satan back to the pits of hell from which he came from, oh God. And God, we ask him to take his hands off the city of North, to take his hands off of the children. Oh, now, God, we pray now, God, that you will continue to give us the victory. And because we have the victory, we are victorious. Because we have the victory, we all know that you are a healer. You are a deliverer. You can set free. You will set free. In Jesus' name, in whom we have the victory. Amen.
Sister Dawn Haynes, the chair, the manager, the coordinator, the organizer of Brick City Peace to Live. Listen, if you want to see what unity looks like, you see this right here, take a really good look. You see this Muslim sister right here, my Muslima? This is what we do. You see the Latino that just prayed? This is what we do. This is what we do, because we are all one. And we serve a one God. How you put it, Minister Abdul? And this is what we want our children to see. We want our community to see this. That it doesn't matter your faith, your color, your religion, whoever you are, as the mayor says it and the word declares it, we are all created in God's image. That don't mean because you dark and I'm light that we any different. I'm just as good as you and you just as good as me. Sister Dawn Haynes, here you go.
Thank you, Reverend Brownchi. As she stated, my name is Dawn Haynes. I am a manager of the Brick City Peace Collective out of the Office of Violence Prevention. We had a very hard week this week, and it's not falling on deaf ears or spirits that don't want to do this work and fight for it as just as we need to. The conditions of a people will not change unless we change it ourselves with our hearts first and then with our hands. And I am grateful for the space that we in today. I ain't coming here to pray. I just wanted to let y'all know that we have people out here doing work. I'm grateful for all collaborations. The mayor made it very clear. We have to work together. Nothing that we're doing in silos is effective if we're not being able to show that we're changing the conditions of our city. Violence is a public health issue. We're working on that. Making sure that our community is well aware of the resources that we offer. We're working on that. And we need all hands on deck, all boots on the ground, coming to the schools, coming to the community, Speak to these babies as we see them, because if we don't change our conditions, they're not going to change. And with that being said, peace and enjoy the rest of your day.
Come on, put your hands together for Sister Dawn. And the rest of this is going to just be prayer. I'm not going to do all this talking, but Minister Abdul-Haq, you inspire me. And when I see this 19-year-old brother right here that since he's been 13 has given his life to a spiritual walk, I know there's hope. We got a lot of young people out here that just need to understand that there's hope. I see Pastor Matthew P.A., if you don't get yourself up on these steps over there, another one of our young youth ministers that stand along with this young man called Minister Abdul-Haq Muhammad and Minister Malik. But the children in this city, we have a mayor that is, and we know, solution-driven. But what's really important is we got a lot of people doing a lot of talking. And they're talking about things that we really should be doing things about instead of talking about. We can talk all day long. We got a mayor that's offering programs. We have programs like BCPC. We have an Office of Violence Prevention. But while we on social media showing the problem, what part of the solution are we? So as I stand here today, you will never see a funeral I went to. You will never see a shooting I went to. And I've been doing it for 8 years because I want to speak life in the community. It don't mean we ain't there, but we want to speak life. So my social media page don't host that stuff. And we got to learn, preachers, faith leaders, and community, and whoever else out there listening, be a part of the solution. Don't contribute to the problem for our babies. Be what you want, emulate what you, be the example you want them to be. Now, if you don't want to be nothing, stay away from our babies. If you don't want to do nothing positive, stay away from the babies. Because we out here struggling, trying to keep them from shooting each other and thinking that it's okay to, anyway, y'all know what I'm saying. And come on, we gonna go ahead and pray. Because the truth is, I tried to just keep my peace and keep peace with these babies. It's not easy for the North Interfaith Alliance to show up at funerals and shootings and have to hold mother's hands and grandmama's hands. And it's not easy. And it don't hurt until it hits your house. Now. Okay, I got it. He said, wrap it up with that. No. I got to bring one young lady here and our African. You going to pray, but
hallelujah. We come to the city hall today to pray and nothing else. Because when the people gather together in God's name, they pray and the Lord will answer. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, our Lord and our God, the giver of life, you are God. And God and God by yourself, you never fail. You said, come unto me, all ye. That is why we gather together. At the step of the city hall, we come before you, our Lord and our God, who is like unto you. Today, let there be peace in our city. In the mighty name of Jesus, let there be peace in our city. In the mighty name of Jesus. When Jordan become an impediment for the Israelites to go through, they call upon Elijah. Elijah smote Jordan, and Jordan parted. Today we gather together at this step, oh Lord, and we are smacking every power, every authority that is working against the city in the mighty name of Jesus. And Moses tell the Israelites that the problem that you see today will come to an end, that you will see them no more. We stand as an authority that is working on behalf of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every problem that is emanating, that is affecting the city, we come against you right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Maukabahuna rakiba masesis. Lerikaba masekekelia raka. Maula rakiba masekekelia raka. Lord God of heaven, let your peace, let it reign in our city. We bring the mayor before you, Lord. We ask you that you continue to lead and to direct his path. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give you all the thanks. We give you all the glory because your peace has returned to our city. In Jesus Christ's precious name we pray. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. God of Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac, God of Israel, and God of your people today, all that are created by you, God, and that's each and every one of us here today, and those at the sound of my voice are created by you, God. We are all your creation. And we come today, God, in supplication and prayer, seeking your face, seeking the authority of the heavens, seeking the authority of God. Lord God, that you would dispatch the angels by the millions to encamp in every ward of our city. We come against the evil in the name of Jesus. We come against the things that would take the minds of the people, that would imprison the mind of the people to bring violence against one another. We bind it up in the name of Jesus. We bind it up by the power and the authority of God in which he has given to us on today. We declare the victory. We declare healing in our city. We declare, hallelujah, peace in our city. God, in the name of Jesus, we believe the authority of God. We believe the power of God. We are not here to be seen or heard, but we are here to stand proxy, hallelujah, as vessels that God can be used, hallelujah, to declare the peace of God, to declare the power of God. And we take back the city of Newark, every cranny, every crimp, hallelujah, every corner, wherever the enemy think he's hiding, we are calling forth the angels of light, the angel of Gabriel message, the angel of Uriel light, the angel of Michael war. We are calling the angels of God, hallelujah, to encamp in our city, in every ward. We are five wards, one city, and we are coming today believing God for the victory. And as I close this prayer, Lord, we ask you, Lord God, to, hallelujah, touch the families of those that are hurting today, those that are bereaved, that have lost their loved ones by senseless violence. Oh God, we are praying, God, that you will impact them right now, Lord, with your spirit of peace and strength, in the name of Jesus. This prayer I pray by faith, and I count it to be done in Jesus' name. And all of those in agreement say amen. Amen and amen. Glory to God.
Eternal God, our Father, we thank you, we praise you today. Father, we honor you, we give you glory today. Father, we thank you for joining together in unity. Your word declares how good and how pleasant for brothers to dwell together in unity. Father, we come united like never before. Father, that you will move in the midst of our city like never before. God, we submit to your plan, for when a man's ways please you, God, you will direct our path. And Father, you said to trust in the Lord with all our heart. Lean not to our own understanding, but all our ways acknowledge you, and you will direct our path. Many are the plans of man, but it is the Lord's that will prevail. God, we submit to your plan today. We submit to your will today. We submit to your word today. And we say, be it done in the name of Jesus. For Father, you have called us to pray this prayer, a prayer that will cause change in the earth in this hour. Oh God, as we're praying, we're not waiting for after the prayer, but as we pray, oh God, things are shifting in the city. Oh God, as we pray, things are shifting in the heaven. It's already done in the heaven, so shall it be in the earth. Father, we're waiting for any day now manifestation. We're waiting for any day now report that violence has stopped. We're waiting for any day now that we have stood to speak truth to power, to stand and to tell the enemy there will be no more premature death, for the thief coming to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But God, you declare, I'll come that they may have life, and life more abundantly. Oh God, we come against suicide. We know that this is a holiday time. We know that this is a time where we gather, and we gather in love. But there is somebody that's depressed. There is somebody, oh God, that is hurting, and they feel like giving up at this very hour, oh God, but we use our words to speak life where they are. We use our words to speak to my brother and sister, said, don't end it here. There is more to live for. When you are fearfully and wonderfully made, we cancel suicide in the name of the Lord Jesus. Oh God, and raise us up that we can impart the love in their hearts that they need. Oh God, we declare now there is no poverty in the name of the Lord Jesus. David said, I've been younger and now I'm older, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor a seed begging for bread. There will always be bread. But Paul said, God shall supply all our needs according to his riches and glory. God, we're not waiting on you. You're waiting on us. So Father, help us to align ourselves that you can manifest your word. Your word is already done. So Father, we wait for the manifestation now. We're not waiting on you, God, but you're waiting for us to get into a proper alignment. If my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray. Father, as we have humbled ourselves, as we have turned from the thing that have hindered us from you, Father, you said that you will heal our land. So, Father, we thank you today. Father, work the work in this hour. Let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord. There shall be strength. There shall be countless victories because of this time of prayer. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen, and thank God.
I just want to thank you, Bishop, Pastor Hicks, Queen Mother Amaku, representing our committee faith. I'm going to tell y'all something. We're getting ready to close because some folks are a little cold. Pastor Dingle, you all right? Oh, okay. Bless the Lord. Sister Bimri, who came out, she's had visions to pray, and we're just going to trust God for her. But the last three people that are going to pray, and I'm going to give you 60 seconds. Amen. 60 seconds. The Kemetic faith is our base. Queen Mother, 60 seconds. Bishop Crone, 60 seconds. Is it 1 o'clock yet?
No.
What time is it? Oh, Lord. We got 17 minutes. Okay, you know what? I can't do that. Queen Mother, Bishop Crone, Reverend Marquise, and Chaplain Sharia is going to close us out.
Give thanks and praise. In ancient Kemet, our African ancestors would call out Ur Shedi, which is calling out to the Savior, and they would envision a turtle shield, which would cover them. God, cover us. God, cover us. I want you to envision being covered right now. Being covered. God, cover us. And envision our children being covered in protection. Envision our city being covered in protection. Divine Limitless Creator, we thank you so much for this day. We thank you for this company of holy people coming in good intention in this moment, in good intention, wanting the best for this city, for our children, for our families, for the people of Newark. We thank you for your love, for your protection that comes to us in every day. And we ask that you get the mind straight of those who do not understand your love, who do not understand your strength, do not understand our strength. And we ask that you bring purity of purpose. We ask that you cover us. We ask that you cover them as you bring them to the correctness of mind. Heal them. Heal us as a city. Bring us to a place of purity. Cover us. Shadi, cover us. Please continue to strengthen us. We ask that you bless and protect our mayor, his family, everyone who works in this building, from every element of government. We ask that you would continue to strengthen the city of Newark as we move forward. And for everyone who has been hurt, we ask that you bring healing of heart, body, and mind. And we continue to thank you and give you all of the praise every single day. We don't understand everything that happens. We ask you to bring us strength and wisdom and continue to bring us closer together as a family in this city. Amen. Amen.
Our Father and our God, we thank you for this opportunity. We thank you for this time. We believe you for deliverance. We thank you for the victory. We thank you for the overcoming power. We thank you for the joy of the Lord. We thank you. We thank you that things are changing, that things are turning in our favor. We thank you, God, for miracles, favor, and blessings over this whole city, over this state of New Jersey. We pray in the name of Jesus that you would strengthen these your people, these your children. We pray in the name of Jesus that you would rain down on us the blessings of the Lord, that you would put us in a state of mind that we would serve you. For you said in your word, let this mind be in you that was also in Christ. We thank you for it right now. Thank you for every blessing. Thank you for you are our shepherd and we shall not want. In Jesus' name, amen.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you, feeling the shift that's in this room, knowing, oh God, that you are here. So we know, oh God, victory is on the way. Oh Father, we come to you declaring, oh God, that Nork still should rise. Rise in the turmoil that we're in, oh God. We know, oh God, that you will never leave us or forsake us. So we come believing, oh God, that you already stopping the crime. We believe, oh God, that some young man's mind is already being transformed, oh God. We believe, oh God, that someone's putting down the guns right now, oh God. We believe in, oh God, that our schools are safe, oh God. We come to you, oh God, believing that we're going to rise in the midst of this turmoil, oh God. We come believing, oh God, that you said that you will be with us every step of the way, that you will prepare a place for us in the presence of our enemy. So we come today, oh God, knowing that not all of us are here, oh God, because we want to see victory. But we also know that some are here praying on us. So we come, oh God, knowing, oh God, that you're stronger than our enemy. Oh God, we come here knowing, oh God, that you are bigger than any of our problems. We come to you, oh God, declaring that you have put a man in office for a time such as this, who is our mayor. And we come, oh God, believing, oh God, that you gave him the vision, that you gave him the strength, oh God, to get us through a time like this. So we come, oh God, believing that is already done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen.
Glory, glory, glory. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, who he has redeemed from the hand of the enemy. So, Lord, we come with bowed heads and humble hearts to give your name glory, to give your name honor, and to give your name praise. We thank you, dear God, for seeing fit and so fit for us to assemble again on these steps on this afternoon. Even now, oh God, we come to you lifting up our leaders, the Interfaith Alliance, the North Interfaith Alliance, and the Mayor Office of Clergy Affairs. We thank you, oh God, for our leaders. We thank you, oh God, for their leadership, and even going through a time of cold and madness within our city, we stand together in unity and we stand together in love. So while we continue to be there for our people, we ask God for the strength of the community. We ask God for the leaders to return back to the community. And even now, God, while we continue to thank you for our leaders, we continue to thank you for the leader that you have placed over us, oh God. We thank you for the Reverend Dr. Louise Roundtree, oh God. We thank you for her leadership. We thank you for her willingness. And we thank you for her leading in the spirit of excellence. And even now, oh God, while she continues to stand on the front line in mainland for our family. We pray right now in Jesus' name that you continue to send someone to stand on the front line and mainland for her family. And even now, oh God, while we continue to lift up our city, God, we continue to pray that all will be well. And even while we are watching what the enemy is doing, we have to continue to watch what God is doing. We're watching, God, mend broken hearts. We're watching, God, deliver. So even now, oh God, we are praying that you set free. We are binding up the spirit of confusion. We are binding up the spirit of domestic violence. We are binding up the spirit of suicide and homicide. We ask right now in Jesus' name that God continue to send the resources that the mayor may need to be able to govern this city. We know one man was elected, but one man can't do it alone. So we stand in agreement with our mayor of this city. We stand in agreement with our governor that in this season and in this holiday season that all will be well. And while we are trusting God to do a new thing in our community, we will not bow down to the enemy's devices. We will stand bold in what God said. And in God's word, he said that he will be with us. He said that he will never leave or forsake us. That's why in this season of holidays, we are praying that you move with an open eye. We are praying that you move with an open spirit. And even now, oh God, we are praying for the safety of our community. And while we are praying for the safety of our community, we are lifting up to you the women of this community. We know oftentimes the women are forgotten. We know oftentimes our brothers are going through. So we are praying for the resources for the women. We are praying for the resources for the men. We are praying for the resources to be there for the families that are in need. So even now, oh God, we continue to pray for the missing. We continue to pray for the family that has found them. We continue to pray for all that are still missing. We continue to pray for the families that are trusting God to be able to bring their loved one home. So on today, we continue to thank God for what he's already done. And we're going to continue to declare a word over this city that although it may have been shootings, although there may have been much violence, we are praying that even in this season, God could turn it around. So even in this season, we are not ignorant. You know who wear those coats. So you see the videos that the police are showing. You know who's shooting up that block. You know, and now not you turning a blind hand, a blind eye. We are not ignorant to the enemy's devices. Yes, we too come from this city. And yes, we too know who has done certain things. So even now, God, while we are praying for a true deliverance, that your people will not shoot up this city. We are praying for a true deliverance, that there will be no more sexual stuff, sexual abuse, suicide and homicide. I pray against that because it ain't just in this season. It's just the season of holidays and the season of Thanksgiving. So in this season, while we continue to trust God to be able to be with our city, we continue to pray for our law enforcement because we know they cannot get used to seeing what's happening on this ground. So we pray not just for our law enforcement. We pray for our public safety workers, our firefighters, our EMT and EMS workers. While we are praying and trusting God to be with them, we are trusting God that they may have the resources they need to be able to govern this city and beyond. Because we know that now that we need the resources, we know now that we are trusting God to do it. And we know that the police can't do it alone. We know that the cameras are working. So even if the cameras are not working on your business, we're asking that you restore them. Because we know now that God said in his word that he sees all things and knows all things. So we are not ignorant. So on today, while we stand with our leaders, while we trust with our leaders, we thank you, God, for our leaders' faithfulness. Because even in a time as such as this, our leaders are going through too. So we are praying for the leaders that are suffering in silence. We are praying for the love and family, God. And even now, oh God, while we continue to lift up our community, we ask right now for everyone that is watching someone else's child walk these streets. We ask that you open your eyes and ears that no other child will have to go hurt. So even now, God, while we continue to trust you to bring unity within our community, while we continue to trust you to make a way out of no way for all that is suffering. And before I go, I continue to lift up our neighbors with our addresses, God. We pray right now in Jesus' name that even in this season of Thanksgiving, that no one will go without. So if you see them on the corners, if you see them on the steps, if you see them down at Penn Station, be a blessing to them and bless them without judgment. So while we pray by faith that God's will would be done in our community, in our state, in our city, and among this world, we are praying peace, peace, peace. Peace in our streets, peace in our community, peace in our finances, peace in our family, and peace among our leadership. And we pray by faith that God's will be done by the power of the Holy Spirit. By faith, we pray by faith, because without faith, it is impossible to please God. So by faith, by the power of the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' Hallelujah, Lord. Glory to your name, God.
That's really enough right there. That right there covered everything. Sister Bembry, tomorrow you can meet me at the Trek Center and open up in prayer at 12 o'clock. You can be one. I'll tell you, okay? But and whoever else did not pray today, I'll look for you tomorrow because I know we're hitting the 1 o'clock hour. I want to seal everything that's been done today. Thank you, BCPC. Thank you. Come on, let's give them a... Let's put our hands together in the atmosphere for BCPC joining us. Minister Abdul Haq Muhammad, do you want to say something before I seal it? Let's bless God for Minister Abdul Haq Muhammad. Come on, come on, come on. Y'all think this is closed? You better think about them people sleeping on the railroad tracks, and y'all will get hot real quick. People sleeping on park benches. I'm not cold at all. Like my hands got a little cold, but every time I think about heat and cold, I think about hell and homeless. So I'm good. Anyway, thank you all for coming. Thank you, Minister Abdul Haq, visionary and man of God. And to all of you who joined us today on these steps, on behalf of the mayor and 311,000 residents, thank you for going before the throne of grace. Now we trust that as you leave this place, that God will cover each and every one of you and your households. In this season of Thanksgiving, we thank God for the opportunity to breathe because we couldn't have done this in 2020. But what was going on now wasn't going on in 2020 either because we was all on lockdown. So we thank God, and as we seal all the prayers that have gone forth, my prayer is, as I always close, is that God will continue to be in our mayor, all of us, to strengthen us, that God will continue to go before all of us, to guide us, that God will continue to be beneath all of us, to support us, as God supports those who govern in this building, the mayor and the municipal council, as God continues to keep loving arms of protection around us and angels encamped over us as a shelter. We shall be careful not to take credit for the opportunity that God has given all of us to speak this morning, but to say to God be the glory for the opportunity to stand in proxy on behalf of the people of our city called Newark. We thank you, God. We honor you, God. Now, I prayed in the name of some who call you Jesus. Some call you Allah. Some call you Yahweh, some call you Elohim, and some call you Jehovah. But you are our God and our Creator. Amen, Amen, and Ashe. I'm going to say it again. Amen, Amen, and Ashe. Hotep, power to the people. Power to the people. Peace in our streets. Peace in our streets. Peace in our streets. Peace in our streets. I can't hear y'all. Peace in our streets. Peace in our streets. Peace in our streets. No justice. No justice. No justice. No justice. Peace in our what? Peace in our